morning, everyone. Delighted to be here in Ballinasloe this morning. Beautiful sunny morning, and I'm delighted that we're after putting down the MEPs in second place today, so we're delighted. And I'm delighted to welcome our MEP, Colm Markey, Senator Dolan, and all our distinguished guests. We have a lot of big shots here today, so you're all very welcome. So I'm pleased to be here with you today at Europe Direct Public Library. The Europe Direct Centre here at Ballinasloe is one of seven Europe Direct Centres around Ireland, which are managed by the Public Library Service. The service and professionalism shown by the staff of the Library Service and to their embrace of new technologies over the last few years enables them to deliver a range of online services which supported people across the country during multiple lockdowns. Libraries have shown themselves to be at the forefront of change and innovation, and it is this focus on the future and on delivery of high quality information which makes the partnership with Europe Direct a natural fit. The Europe Direct network has been established to actively promote European citizenship within schools and colleges, to organise citizens' debates and information sessions, and to provide factual and timely information on a wide range of European policies, supports and services. With the geopolitical and environmental changes we have seen over the last few years, as well as the more recent pandemic, it has become clearer than ever that accurate, factual information must be accessible to the public in order to ensure democratic stability. The Europe Direct network provides the means and the opportunity for EU citizens to access information, to find out about opportunities for study, apprenticeships and working in Europe.
I think this is a wonderful initiative because one of the things we struggle with at Europe is to relate what's happening at European level back to the ordinary citizen on the ground. And one of the things in relation to that we're doing at the moment is developing a conference on the future of Europe, which is specifically because of, I suppose, the challenge that's there around how Europe to some degree is becoming disconnected from the people on the ground. And it's initiatives like this that gives the opportunity to bring that link back. I suppose when you look at the broader political situation at the moment, there's, if you like, something of a disconnect among the people with the institutions of Europe. In the past, Ireland was a place which greatly valued, if you like, what happens at European level. But probably with the accession countries that came into Europe in the early 90s, we somewhat got a little bit disconnected from Europe. I suppose our early days it was very much about funding. But I think we have to reinvent what Europe means to us. And in the last 12 or 18 months with the COVID pandemic, the like of the vaccines, the likes of the digital certificate, they made Europe more relevant to people on the ground. And what we want to do through a centre like this is to start that conversation and develop that conversation at European level. I'm not used to these formalities, now do they? The very special unveiling of the plaque, so.